Hi guys, we will have a last view at the parts from the frequency generator. So first this dial assembly, I will take it apart right now because it seems there are some mechanism inside. So it is just a matter of removing a few screws. You can see the nice brass piece in the middle here, quite seriously made. So there is a little dial in the middle here, which should come. And there is the larger dial here with a little screw. And the two locking parts. Here we are for this. As you can see, there is some handwritten stuff inside. From 1974, very nice. The middle dial, and here is the mechanism inside. I can see ball bearings, nice brass part here, and this aluminium piece. So let's luckily the screws are already loosened because if not you never know. Here we are, so it should come right off, yes. So there is this part, maybe it can be used for something. And there is this mechanism assembly, you can see ball bearings here. So what it does in fact, yes, it is for demultiplicating the between the large and central and coarse and fine knobs you had on the front panel, it seems. Okay, so what else? Another view at the drum with the coils. You can see there are coils of increasing values, inductors, this one, the worst one. This one with a little more wire, this one with a thin wire, and then more and more thin wire until this one. The contacts are these silverish rings on the ceramic shaft here. So it is possible to take this apart and change the parts. Interesting. Then the micro ampmeter indicator, as you can see now, it is all cleaned. You have here the logo of the factory and also on the wax seals of the screws. And it is working fine. Manufacturing date here, serial number, and made in USSR, in Cyrillic. Brass screws, very very nice. Then the PCB which was attached on the side of the core unit with new Vistar tube here, its leads, one vacuum tube, and trim pots. Other PCB with tubes, the one with which was connected to the heatsink. So this one is not so great. As you can see, next part, the main variable capacitor. It is two capacitors here. You can see how it is made. Very, very nice. It can be taken apart completely, it seems. But on this unit, here was a vacuum tube. And the problem is when you took it apart, all the leads did break loose because they were oxidized. The copper lid, it seems, and they were completely rotten and did break loose. You can see how it is made. Very, very nice. Ball bearings, the clips. And there is a second one with a single air capacitor inside. And here you have one more new Vistar tube with a little auxiliary air capacitor here. Really, really nice. So these parts may be used for some radio project, maybe. Okay. It seems there are this block here is die-cast aluminium. It seems a block of machine aluminium, not so. But it is really nicely made. These are the contacts which were making connection to this part here, like this. Okay, some mechanical parts and auxiliary parts. This is one of the high frequency wires with a special plug on it. Some indications here about the model of the plug. And the wire is Teflon wire. Very thick insulation here. Some metal mesh to make a ground connection. Then there are a few interesting mechanical bits, like this shaft here. It is mounted on ball bearing, but the ball bearing is pretty bad on this one. There is another one here, which is better. So it can be useful for something. And some metal gears, which were mounted also. This one is in brass, like on old clocks. And more parts like this. And it is almost everything for this thing, I believe. So, as you can see, the core unit is now empty. I just need to unsolder the inductors here in order to save them. It will be pretty easy, and then this part will go to the scrapyard. Because it is quite a weight of aluminium, it has some value, and anyway, I can do nothing with it. So, thanks for watching, and see you soon for something else. Bye bye!